Elon Musk is going to have five big surprises for us in 2021. Are you ready? Let's go. The first big surprise is the Tesla Model A. Or Model A. Tesla has a lineup of sexy cars. The Model S, the Model 3, which is an E, the Model X, the Model Y. They have Cybertruck coming. They have the Roadster coming, and they have Semi coming. Well, what's going to go in the A slot? If people have talked about the ATV that was shown off at the Cybertruck reveal, I don't think so. It's going to be the Model A, the small sedan that will be designed in China that Elon talked about at the Shanghai Model 3 delivery event.
Great China Design and Engineering Center to actually design an original car in China for worldwide consumption.
In 2016, Elon released the Master Plan Part Deux. Deux is French for two, if you don't know that. And in the Master Plan Part Deux, Elon talked about what's coming. He specifically said he did not think they would make a smaller vehicle than the Model 3. He said a lower cost vehicle than the Model 3 is unlikely to be necessary. The reason for that was twofold. First, Elon felt that their improvements in manufacturing with the Model 3 would so dramatically reduce the cost of producing the Model 3 that a lower cost vehicle would not be necessary. However, so far it looks like the best that Tesla will be able to achieve with the Model 3 is to get the manufacturing cost down to maybe $25,000, maybe $20,000.
So the current cost of Model 3 robo-taxi is less than $38,000. We expect that number to improve over time. Say long term, 3 years, robo-taxis with eliminated parts, it maybe ends up being $25,000 or less.
But if they decided to do a smaller vehicle, the reduction in the amount of material involved, maybe improved manufacturing processes because of an improved design, put all that together and you may be able to get down to a $10,000 cost of production for the Model A. It's called the Model A because the character for, they can't use Model A because that is a Ford trademark. Just like they used Model 3 instead of Model E, using Model A, using the Chinese character for moon, which is pronounced A, when the Chinese use it to do an American alphabet or an English alphabet, they pronounce it A. So that character would make sense with a China design model and would get around the Ford trademark issue. The Model A will be a smaller CUV, a compact utility vehicle, similar to the Model Y, but smaller in size, really seating four more than five, probably no third row capacity, but much lighter weight. And a key detail of this smaller vehicle is because of the lower weight and the improved efficiency, Tesla will be able to go to a much smaller battery pack. If the current battery pack is 50 kilowatt hours, and they're able to get this vehicle down to a 25 kilowatt hour battery pack while still maintaining 200 miles of range, maybe 180 miles of range, but maybe they can get it to 200. Then with 25 kilowatt hour battery packs, you're able to make twice as many vehicles. If you every vehicle has to have a 50 kilowatt hour battery pack, then if you make 50 gigawatt hours of batteries, you can only use so many, you can only make a million cars. But if you use 25 kilowatt hour battery packs, you can make 2 million cars. So getting the size down and getting the size of the battery pack down will allow Tesla to produce more vehicles, to increase the number of vehicles out there and the number of robo-taxis, and that will accelerate the transition to sustainable energy. The number two big surprise is the Tesla bus, or the Tesla Minibus. Again, in the Master Plan Part Deux, Elon talked about needing high passenger density urban transport. He was very specific that they would shrink the size of buses, eliminate the center aisle, putting seats where there are currently entryways. The idea is to increase the density of seats on the vehicle. And this has tremendous potential, not so much for current Tesla consumers, but for the for poorer people, for people who have less resources, whether in other countries or like my homeless client that I interviewed previously. The cost of even a low-cost robo-taxi may be too much for them, but if you create some kind of mass transit that is more convenient and more efficient than current mass transit, spreading the cost of the miles out over 10 passengers, let's say, instead of 2 passengers, or instead of 60 passengers on a municipal bus, just spreading that cost over 10 passengers dramatically reduces the cost to travel for people who can't afford more expensive forms of travel. Elon has been talking about the minibus since 2016. He said it would be built on a Model X chassis. I suspect that that will change. I think that Tesla has found efficiencies in manufacturing, and the chassis for the Model X is now outdated, and it will make more sense to use maybe the Model 3, Model Y chassis, or to use the Cybertruck chassis, whatever that's going to be, because the Cybertruck chassis is going to be larger and more capable. The wheelbase is longer, the width is wider. So I believe that will be more capable of handling a minibus architecture than either the Model X, which is outdated for manufacturing purposes, and the Model 3, which may be too small. Number three is the Boring Company. We are going to see a radical expansion in Boring Company projects. We have already seen that the Las Vegas project has gone well, and there are very clear hints that the Las Vegas project will be expanded to create tunnels to go to the casinos and the Las Vegas airport. We have seen a proposed Tesla Boring Company project in Ontario, California, and San Bernardino, Rancho Cucamonga, California, where Tesla would be boring a 2.8 mile tunnel system to take people from an existing transit line to the airport, a connection that doesn't exist yet. There have been proposals to do such a connection that were dramatically more expensive than what Tesla proposes to do. It looks like this is going to happen, but that's just the beginning. As the Boring Company improves their cost structure, as they increase the number of boring machines that they have, because remember, it's about the machine that builds the machine, it's very likely that the Boring Company is building more boring machines to take on more projects. And we may see projects in a variety of locations. Las Vegas is clearly going to go big. It would make sense for the Boring Company to do projects in Texas, where Tesla is planning on potentially opening a factory and has other, and SpaceX has multiple operations in Texas. It might make sense in Florida. I know personally, living in South Florida, seeing a Boring Company tunnel going past the Golden Glades interchange and making it easier to get in and out of Miami would be a dramatic improvement. But not just in the United States. What about China? And not just regular transit projects, but what about Hyperloop, which we're going to talk about next? There's an important connection here that the Boring Company apparently will be using Tesla-made vehicles for these loops, and this may be where the minibus comes in, that the minibus would be hyper efficient, that it would be more efficient going through tunnels where there's less traffic and maybe less air resistance if they design the tunnels a certain way. This could be big.
And then one day it will connect to the Hyperloop. But that's for another time.
Number four is Hyperloop. They've been making a lot of progress on Hyperloop, and Elon said on July 1st that they are aiming to do a 10-kilometer test tunnel with curves to better approximate a real-world tunnel. That's getting much, much closer to Hyperloop becoming possible. I think one of the interesting questions is, will Hyperloop ultimately run above ground in tunnels built above ground, or will Hyperloop run in Boring Company tunnels? I think that Boring Company tunnels make more sense, underground tunnels, but we will see. Nevertheless, I think we're going to get closer to seeing a demonstration Hyperloop project that would make a lot of sense in a lot of places. I wouldn't be surprised if it was Shanghai to Beijing. Shanghai to Beijing Hyperloop would be amazing. I think the Chinese government may be more ahead of governments in the United States in embracing technology like this. If Elon Musk companies are able to deliver something amazing like that, I could see China going for it when the United States might not be ready to adapt because we're just becoming too slow. Number five, I think we're going to start seeing hints of Starship 2.0. Elon has talked occasionally about Starship 2.0. I made a video before about Starship 2.0. If you look on this image, the Starship on the left is the current Starship 1.0. The Starship next to it is my take on Starship 2.0. To the far right is someone else's interpretation of Starship 2.0 being much, much taller. And Elon acknowledged that version as being possible. I think the version I had would be too short, and there's reasons why that's not the best approach, and a taller approach will be better. Once Starship is up and running, and they actually have, and should be by the end of 2020, we're going to see Starship 1.0 up and running. At least some test flights, you know, some orbital flights, and certainly in the middle, by the middle of 2021, Starship 1.0 should be running fine, the 9-meter diameter Starship. So at some point, Elon's going to say, okay, we've got this working good. Let's start developing Starship 2.0, which is going to have an 18-meter diameter. And for the 2024 Mars missions, for the 2022 Mars mission, which is just going to be bringing some cargo to Mars, it will probably be Starship 1.0. But if they can get Starship 2.0, an 18-meter Starship that much bigger, ready by 2024, that would make the progress towards a Mars colony go much, much faster. So I am optimistic that we're going to start seeing hints of Starship 2.0 in 2021. Now, I gave my list of five, but I think there's a couple of bonus ones here. Here's a couple of bonus ones for you. Robotaxi isn't really a surprise, but the Robotaxi network will go live in 2021. Elon has talked about foundational rewrite of the software by the end of 2020. Probably a lot earlier than the end of 2020. The foundational rewrite will be out in the wild. It will be learning much, much faster due to 3D labeling and other advantages. So Robotaxi is going to happen, and not a surprise to anyone who follows Tesla, but to those who don't follow Tesla or don't believe in the mission, Robotaxi is coming in 2021. Neuralink will be in a human patient in 2021. I made a video about Neuralink. Check it out. Neuralink is going to be amazing. It's going to revolutionize our world. It's going to revolutionize human life and human consciousness. And we are going to see the beginnings of Neuralink in 2021 with blind patients seeing or paraplegic, quadriplegic patients being able to walk, restoring movement. Tremendous change coming. This is going to be really exciting. And one final thing for those who dispute my take on robotaxis, I want to remind people that back in 2019, Elon said himself that Tesla would stop selling cars to consumers. I've said this a couple of times in a couple of my videos, and I get a lot of pushback from people saying no. Elon said it in 2019, then he clarified people will still be able to buy Teslas, but they will be outrageously expensive because their value as a robotaxi will be so high. He said this on July 8th, 2019, a little less than a year ago today. So Tesla will stop. If you want a Tesla and you want to have a Tesla in your garage, buy your Tesla soon. Get a reservation in a Cybertruck. Buy a Model Y, supposedly one of the most spectacular cars ever made. Get it done. Get it happening. This is going to be fun. If you're interested in robotaxis, if you're interested in Neuralink, if you're interested in The Boring Company, check out my videos. I've got some more detail on them, and I've got more coming. I'm going to do in-depth videos based on the five things I talked about here today. Thanks very much for watching.